Guten Tag. I'm so bored during this quarantine. I wish I could find a nice theory to apply to this case I've been working on.
Yeah, it's wild out there. Hold on to your toilet paper. But what's your case?
All right, so I have this patient, Becky. She's a 66-year-old woman diagnosed with stage 4 congestive heart failure. She wants to be DNR, but she has kids, and they don't want to lose her. They said they'll still call 911 if she stops breathing, even if she has her DNR. This is causing her some emotional pain on top of her already physical pain. She doesn't know which route to take. Her kids keep asking me if there's something, if there's more treatments we can do to prolong her life. But I can tell Becky is suffering. I just don't know what to do. I'll take a look.
Theories. I'm the end of life theory. My friends describe me as a middle range predictive theory. My passion is to help people and their families on their transition through the end of life. I have 5 main concepts that allow me to do this. Being free from pain, experiencing comfort, experiencing dignity and respect, being at peace, and experiencing a closeness to significant others.
I like her core concepts, but I want to see more.
Hi, I'm the theory of illness trajectory. I'm a middle range grounded theory. I focus on oncology nursing practice by trying to understand the uncertainties faced by chronically ill cancer patients during their illness trajectory. My goal is to describe a target state for what nurses should be aware of when dealing with the needs of patients with chronic illness, the uncertainty they may face, and how it affects their care.
These are some great theories. I could apply both of them and have a good outcome. This is going to be tough. Maybe I should keep looking.
Hi, I'm the uncertainty and illness theory. I recognize that unresolved uncertainty over a long period of time can cause emotional distress. My goal is to understand the uncertainty that patients experience when going through acute and chronic illness.
Maybe one more will help me decide.
Hello, I'm the theory of comfort. My focus is on achieving a state of comfort for patients and allowing them to engage in health-seeking behaviors leading to increased quality of care. I'm passionate about addressing the needs of individuals in a holistic manner that acknowledges both context and type of comfort.
Oh man, I like them all. Let's see what my friends have to say.
Oh my goodness, Greta. Did you hear that Thomas Foth is on that new Singles Theories app?
Yes, Heidi, I did. He told me all about these theories he's met and asked for my opinion on them, but I'd like to hear yours too.
All right, well, I think the two of us together can maybe help him make a decision. So let's look at the first theory. So she was the end of life theory. I think she seemed really nice. I really loved how she cares about the dying process and making it peaceful. And I really think Becky would benefit from the 5 concepts that are described in this theory, especially the one about experiencing closeness to the significant others during the dying process.
Yeah, she's a super important theory in palliative care, focusing on peaceful end of life, but it can't be applied after death. Once Becky passes away, this theory won't help her children at all.
That's a good point. All right. Well, let's move on to the illness trajectory theory. I think she's really applicable to nursing and gives a great understanding of the uncertainties that chronically ill patients face. I think she would really help Becky cope with the dynamics of her illness trajectory as it gives a good kind of understanding of how to work with these uncertainties.
It is so important to consider her emotional state when living with a chronic illness. But this theory was made for oncology patients, and Becky isn't suffering of cancer, so I just don't think that she's the best option for Thomas.
That's true. Yeah, we have to consider her diagnosis as well. Well, let's move on. The next one is the uncertainty in illness theory. I like how she allows nurses in all contexts to alleviate negative uncertainty, and I think Becky seems really uncertain in her decision-making and in her coping. I think if she applied this theory, it might give her some closure and help her to base her healthcare decisions on her own comfort or on the comfort of her kids.
Yes, once again, it's super important to acknowledge her emotions and her uncertainty. But this theorist also came up with her theory after her father was dying of cancer. Becky needs something that's more general and can be applied to all situations and not just oncology.
That's true. All right, well, that only leaves us with one theory left, and that's a theory of comfort. I really like this theory and how it allows both nurses and students to learn how to practice in numerous clinical and research settings and to allow patients to reach an optimal state of comfort, because I think that's what she really needs right now.
Yeah, considering that comfort is the main basis for all nursing interventions, she doesn't consider that comfort might not be the desired state for all cultures and religions. What if Becky finds more comfort in doing what her kids want her to do? But who are we to decide?
Ugh, well, I'm stumped. I honestly do not know which theory Thomas should choose. Like, I think all of them have a lot of benefits, like, for his patient. Because, you know, they all kind of cover different aspects. I don't know.
I think we should tell him to touch base with his TA, Catherine. She'll know what's best.
That's a good idea.
Okay, finally done my lecture for tomorrow. Let me call Professor Falk and see how he's doing. Hi, Professor Foth. Did you use the app I recommended?
Yes, but I still really need help to make my decision.
Oh, Professor Foth, you don't need me to decide for you. Just go with what's best for your patient, Becky.
This is really tough. I can honestly see myself applying all of these to my practice to help Becky. Just mind my choices to apply all of them. Not one single theory is the answer to every patient's situation. Sometimes incorporating the ideas of all the theories is the best option.
Good choice. Bye.
Bye.
I'm a bitch, I'm a boss, I'm a bitch and a boss, I'm a shine like girls, I'm a bitch, I'm a boss.